So the Sonic Frontiers EGX demo has been out for like a couple days now, and a lot of people have been able to go and try the game. Even some of your favorite Sonic content creators have been able to go and play the game and get their thoughts out. We've seen so much new stuff from people capturing footage of the game, such as the Titan battle, the Squid boss fight, more platforming in the open world. And honestly, all this new stuff is just good overall for Sonic Frontiers, and it's helping people change their mind on the game a bit. Because honestly, I guess the best end goal is just for everyone to look forward to the game, or not everyone, but as many people as possible. But it was definitely way too early to write off Sonic Frontiers, and I feel like there's still a decent amount of people that have written it off, which is fine personally, but I just kind of want to discuss what's changed and why it's always too early to judge something like this. Even based off of this EGX demo, it's still very early. But before we hop into that, hey, you there. Yeah, you watching. There's 49,000 people that keep coming back to these videos. I don't really have 49,000 subscribers. Since you guys keep on coming back, why not hit the subscribe button? It really helps out the channel, and so that way you don't have to miss anything. Thanks, guys. So as you guys know, the EGX demo, again, was available to play, but it only was a 15-minute time demo. So if you really wanted to get to the meat of the game, you had to speed run through everything to get to really experience the open world. Because the first 15 minutes are pretty much a tutorial zone, and it's not really as interesting as the open world. So some people kind of feel a little meh after their demo experience, but people who played it multiple times and got further into the demo usually end up liking it a lot more and find the better content. So once again, even the first 15 minutes isn't enough. And we know that Frontiers has an annoying amount of tutorial pop-ups, which has been noted by many, many people, and that probably doesn't help with this demo experience. But one of the first big complaints in Frontiers is the lack of momentum, and that wasn't even entirely true. We just didn't have enough of the gameplay and enough of good marketing to tell us that there was anything like that. The game does have momentum. It just isn't super crazy momentum, but it has momentum. The drop dash has momentum, power boost has momentum, there's some aerial momentum. It exists within the game. It just doesn't seem like it's on foot. And, you know, I kind of get why they did it, I think. I think it has somewhat to do with the whole level up Sonic speed system, because I don't think they want Sonic to reach high speeds without leveling up. So I think they want to force you to level up Sonic in order to reach those high speeds. I think for the next Sonic open world game, they can ditch the whole leveling up Sonic speed thing. I think they can find other things to make better, like upgrading a spin dash or drop dash or side loop. Just focusing more on those kinds of upgrades, I feel like would be a lot cooler than just upgrading Sonic speed. To me, that makes a lot more sense. But one of the big talks of the town right now is the diamond or chaos emerald structure that has been floating around in this open world. And we've been seeing it pretty much ever since the game got shown off, just in the background. Apparently, it's really good to just mess around with that diamond structure because it has normal, well-designed boost level design just surrounding it. And if there's more stuff like this in the open world, I think it'll make the game a lot more fun to a lot more Sonic fans and just people in general, having more level-like things in the open world. I think that will kind of make cyberspace feel like doo-doo even more, to be honest, if there's more cooler things in the open world compared to cyberspace. Another thing is, this is a 20 to 30 hour Sonic game. That is a huge amount of time for a Sonic game and a huge amount of content. So I think it's okay to expect a lot to come and a lot of new things that we just haven't seen. At the end of the day, we haven't even seen the entire first island still. And we've only seen a tiny bit of Ares Island and a tiny bit of the Volcano Island. The Volcano Island we've barely seen. I don't even know what kind of objectives they have going on there. We just see landscapes and Sonic flying on a bird, which looks really cool, by the way. So personally, I don't want to see everything the game has to offer before it comes out, because at the end of the day, it's a game. We still need to experience it for ourselves. And I get that Sonic fans are cautious and they want more information. I usually do too, but I think in this case, we've seen enough, I think, to convince me and I feel like a lot of other people. So at this point, I think they should somewhat slow down on the brand new content, because it seems like we're finding out crazy new stuff that like kind of changes a lot almost every single week. Even about stuff that we previously thought, it turns out it's something different. Like at one point we thought the game had a spin dash that relates to drop dash. People had no idea how this drop dash was going to work, but it was in the game pretty much the whole time and it wasn't really talked about until a bit later on. There's a lot of these things that just kind of pop up and make something better when it comes to Frontiers, or something that rectifies a previous thing that we had thought was not that great. But I'll say this, if the game still doesn't interest you at this point, I think that's perfectly okay. It doesn't really have to interest you. But in my own personal opinion, there isn't that much here that's I think, worth slander. I would say the worst thing about the game to me so far is probably the cyberspace levels, but at least they'll have great music. That Sky Sanctuary theme is way too good. That might be one of my favorite level themes in a long time. It almost sounds like a mix between Sonic R music and Sonic Forces, like custom hero music. Another thing I want to discuss is the combat. From people messing around with the combat and finding cancels and techniques, there's a lot you can do with this combat and a lot of cool stuff, but it just seems like because of how early on the game is, it isn't really that insane because the enemies are kind of weak. I'm hoping over time the game gets a bit harder and has you use more tactics, I guess, which is something that Brian Shea at Game Informer actually did talk about, as he said in his playthrough, things did get more interesting and forced you to be more tactical. So maybe it does get harder later on. And he ended up playing 4 hours of the game, mind you, which is a lot more than a 15-minute demo. Another factor is we don't know how good he was at the game, but he says that it gets, I guess, technically harder over time. Sonic Frontiers is a very interestingly designed game because it literally is a pick what you want to do kind of game. You don't even have to fight the enemies. You can create rings with the Psy Loop, so you can just keep healing yourself, I guess. So I feel like it's a sandbox, really, and you kind of just pick how you want to play. Because I know if I play the game, I probably won't abuse the rings and fights in order to beat the game because I enjoy a challenge. Because if I can simply just do that, I probably won't. I don't know if this exists or not, but I feel like there should be a mechanic where if there's enemies nearby, the Psy Loop doesn't create ring and you just have to pick up your own rings. I feel like that would change something. But I guess a cheese strat to that would be running away from the area, getting rings and coming back. But if that happens, the enemies should get their health back. My opinion, that's a great way to balance the whole Psy Loop giving yourself rings thing. Because I think that's a little crazy, I'm not going to lie. But again, too early to judge. I don't know how this game is going to unfold. That's pretty much the point of this video. Cool new stuff that's happened with this game and why it's probably too early to call a lot of things for this game because we don't have it in our hands yet. And it seems like just more information comes out week by week. So what do you guys think? In the comments below, make sure you hit the subscribe button and hit the like. And I'll see you in the next one.
Well, whatever happens, happens.